Hello, this is Crane Song from Twitch Chat, and you're listening to Civicta on SS Radio.
Hello, this is Sparse Vector, the creator of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure, and you're listening to Civicta on SS Radio.
This is Sailmer, Mr. of the Grendel Podcast, and you are listening to Civicta on SS Radio.
This is Chan Man V of Wednesday Night Sprites and Climbing the Ladder, and you're listening to Civicta on SS Radio.
Hey yo, what up world? I go by the name of Tempo from Team Infinity 7, and you are listening to my brother Civicta on SS Radio.
Hello, this is Nick Axavranish from Major League Gaming, and you're listening to Civicta on SS Radio.
Live on Twitch TV and on the VODs here on YouTube.com, it's SS Radio! 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 And now, here's your host, Civicta. What is up? What is going on? Ladies and gentlemen, a tremendous Thursday evening to all here live and in person. It is SS Radio number 100, the one that everybody has been waiting for, coming at you live here on twitch.tv/Civicta, also broadcasting here on the VODs, youtube.com/Civicta316. Oh my goodness gracious, have we got a spectacular. I wish I could roll my R's like a Spanish speaker, but unfortunately I can't because I am not skilled in pretty much anything. But this is the 100th episode, count them, 100 episode of SS Radio. You can check out all the VODs here on my Twitch channel. Unfortunately, I did have to take a lot of them down from YouTube, but I do have every single VOD archive here at twitch.tv/Civicta. And again, if you want to watch this on YouTube, you can indeed do so without having to download it, without having to stream the video. You can download an app called ProTuber, and that is for the iPhone only for the Mac OS, but you can download ProTuber or ProTube and download it. You can play it in the background while you do other things. It is an amazing app. It forces HD resolutions, and it is outstanding. What have we got in store today? We are giving away five games, the aforementioned five games that we were talking about last week, this time 7 days ago. It seems like it went by like that. Also, we are going to be having my good friend and amazing, you might even say super amazing, creator of Super Amazing SS Radio, Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. I see it's kind of like a muscle reflex there. I'm used to calling it the SS Radio Wagon Adventure. The creator of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure and Go Plague Monkey Go is here. He is back, and he's going to be joining me in studio in just a couple of moments. And we have five copies, count them, five copies to give away of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. This is going to be available, again, for five people. We're going to be doing trivia. It's going to be a whole a lot of fun. And then coming out in the second half of the show, we'll be doing the Civicta Ask Me Almost Anything. If you have any last minute questions, you can email them Civicta316@gmail.com, or you can ask them from the live chat. Again, hold those questions until the second half of the show. I promise you, you will know when I am asking for it. So if you have not seen a live showing of SS Radio, you are in for a treat. This is how we do it. I come back, count back from 3, 2, 1, and then we go to the topic. So 3, 2, 1. There we go. The topics tonight for SS Radio 100. You may notice something a little bit different. It's the return of the custom UI, I think I will call it. And this, of course, is the Sparse Vector. I would call it the Sparse Vector skin for the SS Radio countdown and the UI and everything like that. I've modified it just a little bit, just so it's updated with a nice information and that sort of thing, and making sure that we are all set to go. So we're going to be talking about the winners of the giveaway number 3. I'll go down that line really quick because I do want to get to Sparse Vector again. He will be joining me very, very shortly here on the program for SS Radio 100. Make sure you're taking a drink every time I say 100. I promise you it's going to be a lot of fun. It's going to be very, very frequent. Let's put it that way. And then, of course, coming up in the second topic, we've got my good friend Sparse Vector going to be talking about the Wagon Adventure update as well as Go Plague Monkey Go and other things. And then we're going to be holding a contest, a trivia contest, if you will. So those of you who are regular followers of the show, you will have an edge over people who are just now newly tuning in. I'll be asking 5 separate Super Amazing Wagon Adventure questions all about trivia. Some of them have to do with me. Some of them have to do with the game. Sparse Vector and I, we put his great mind together with my tiny peanut little brain mind of thing and came up with 5 great questions for you. We all agree they're very good. So, we have 5 questions, giving away 5 keys. That is how it's going to go. Sparse Vector will be picking the winner from the people who answer correctly. Again, I will talk about that in just a moment. They're coming out in the second half of the program after the halftime break. We're going to be hopping straight into the Sinvicta Ask Me Almost Anything. That is when I'll be asking for the chat questions. Again, you can still email them. I have my email open right now, sinvicta316@gmail.com. Ask anything you want. I will say for the record, it is my right and my responsibility to not have to answer everything. If there's a question in there that gets a little bit too personal or something that just may not be appropriate, I have the right to not answer. I have the right to refuse to answer that question. And then finally, before the show is over, we are going to be doing the world premiere. The world premiere, world first, whatever you want to call it, server first type deal of the brand new version of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure, version 1.5. Sometimes it may be called Turbo as well. And again, I will be we'll be playing with myself as a traveler, Sparse Vector as a traveler, and H to the Yusky Husky, who's also going to be a traveler, checking out the game as well. And again, this is going to be the world premiere of the brand new updated version of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. I could not be more excited. Now, before we get to Sparse Vector, really quickly, I'm going to be going over the winners of giveaway number 3. Again, we did not have a whole lot of entries, admittedly so. I only got 3 entries for the Photoshop contest, and I take that back. There was another entry, but I did not understand what it meant. Let's put it that way. But we do have 3 winners, and I'm going to be displaying those winners right now. We do have a couple games that were not claimed. Maybe I'll give them away separately in a separate giveaway down the line here, but I'm not going to spend too much time because I do want to talk to my good friend Sparse Vector. So here are the winners for giveaway number 3, and I'm showing you I'm showing you their artwork. So you're going to see the screen flicker really quick and then go to the winners. So congratulations to these 3 fans right here. Congratulations to Dominic, Sada, and Vladimir. You have won the games that you have entered for. So Dominic will be getting a copy of Medal of Honor. Sada will be winning the Burnout Paradise Ultimate Steam Box key. And of course, Vladimir will be receiving a copy of Mirror's Edge for that amazing entry. And for the record, because I know what you're going to say, you're going to be wondering, what exactly is Sada's picture of? Well, my friend, let me tell you, that is my home country sand, and that is the logo. That is the S316 shield logo drawn out in the sand, and also used, Sada also used blades of grass there to spell out the S316. That is what that is, and that is amazing. That is super, I dare say super amazing. So congratulations to Dominic, Sada, and Vladimir for that. Again, I could not be happier, and I was very, very, I was very impressed. I guess the Dominic's entry is the one that's the one that killed me. I died laughing at that one. Then Sada's was just amazing because I loved looking at that. So congratulations to you 3. You will be receiving your keys sometime later on this week in the email that you actually emailed me from. So I'm not going to PM it to you, but I will be emailing the keys to you 3. But here we go. I'm not going to waste any more time. I am pleased and privileged to introduce here on SS Radio number 100, October 3rd, 2013, my good friend, the creator of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure and the creator of Go Plague Monkey Go. I am now joined by Sparse Vector. Sparse Vector, welcome out to the program again, man. How have you been?
I'm doing good. Thanks for having me, and congratulations on 100 episodes.
Hey, I appreciate it. I never would have thought a year ago, from right now, actually a couple more months ago from right now, removed, I should say, but I never would have thought that I would be sitting here doing the 100th episode of SS Radio, talking to a game developer such as the one and only Sparse Vector, and I could not be happier. How have things been going for you? I know you've been super busy, and I do want to thank you for taking the time out to spend with us and all the fans out there on SS Radio 100. How have you been since the last time we talked to you?
I'm doing good. I've been working on the Wagon Adventure update. Super Amazing Wagon Adventure got greenlit thanks to people like you and all your viewers. So I've been working on a new content update to go along with the Steam release.
And I cannot express how excited I am. I will state for the record, I did have to boot up the preview build that Sparse Vector was kind enough to upload to me because I needed to make sure that it ran. I confirmed that it did run, and I have not seen anything. The only thing that I even had a remote inclination of checking out was the character creation, and even then, I didn't scroll through everything. I just wanted to make sure it worked. And again, that was the request from Sparse Vector saying, "Hey, make sure if it crashes, I need to know now." So other than that, I'm looking forward to playing it. And just in case that they don't know who you are, Sparse Vector, this is the very first time that one of my fans or followers have ever heard of you, I guess. How would you introduce yourself, and would you say hello to all the beautiful nerds and nerdettes out there on the interwebs?
Hello, I'm Sparse Vector. I'm a independent game developer. I made Super Amazing Wagon Adventure, and I'm currently working on an update to that game and also a new game called Go Plague Monkey Go.
And what exactly, I guess, the first question that came to mind is, because I was getting a lot of these questions, and people are asking, is this an actual, like, successor sequel type deal to Super Amazing Wagon Adventure, or would you look at this more of like a 1.5, kind of like an expansion release update for the game?
I'd say it's basically just an expansion. It's not, I'm not sure if I'd even call it an expansion, more just like a content update. There's not like a enormous amount of new stuff. There's a fair amount of new stuff, but because of sort of the way the game is structured, a lot of the new stuff is like rare stuff. So you might not even, like, if you just play it once, you might not even see any new stuff. But there's a fair number of new surprises. There's some new wagons, some new weapons, and that kind of stuff.
I cannot wait to see what those are. And I guess the other thing that I will say is, when you found out that the game had been greenlit on Steam Greenlight, was there any doubt that you were going to just re-release it just as standard as it's been for the past couple of years? Or was it just like, I have to do something special and update this game now since it's actually gotten greenlit?
I wasn't sure at first because it's been out for like over a year now, so I sort of didn't want to like mess with something that people have already been playing for a year.
Right.
Yeah, I sort of thought about it, and I thought it would be kind of lame to just like release a year old game on Steam. So I thought I'd, you know, spruce it up a little bit and add some stuff that I didn't get a time to add the first time.
Now, are you, as far as promotion for the game, because I know that we kind of have the working title of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure Turbo, but as other than possibly tacking on the name change there, have you branched out and talked to anyone else as far as people, I mean, who are obviously way cooler and bigger than I am, such as Total Biscuit or anyone to let everyone know that, hey, there's going to be an updated version coming out with a simultaneous release on Steam, or have you not kind of thought that far yet?
I definitely will be doing that. I haven't quite gotten there yet. I sort of just barely am now finished adding all the content to the game, and now I'm sort of switching gears to promoting and like testing and all that stuff.
Right.
But yeah, I'll definitely be doing that hopefully pretty soon.
I'm looking forward to it. I cannot wait to see TB's reaction, especially to the updates. I'm just giddy at the fact that I get to see something new in Wagon Adventure. And one of the questions that I have to ask, Out of, I guess it's a product of my own curiosity, along with my fans' curiosity as well. It's been debated. Is it possible? And again, I'm strictly speaking from kind of my own curiosity's sake. Is it possible that I have played more games of Wagon Adventure, besides, of course, the creator itself, which is you, in the world more than anyone else has, as far as the first version of the game is concerned?
I think that's definitely possible. I'd say that's almost for sure you're the one who's played it the most, like on stream or on camera. Like, I'm not sure. There may be some crazy person somewhere who's played it like nonstop, but
Well, I might be considered crazy for playing the game, but honestly, the game, even after I'm pretty sure I've seen almost everything, there's always something new that comes out of nowhere. I'm like, I've never seen that scene before. I still don't know what the joke text is from people dying to squirrels. I haven't seen what it is. I haven't seen the joke text from, I think the last time that you were on, which was earlier, I believe this year, I could be wrong about that. I'm pretty sure it was this year, the last time you were on. You said that there was a particular funny line whenever you actually get killed by running over an animal. Is that correct?
Yeah, so it's possible to get killed by like the little critters at the very start of the game, but only like if you have a faster than normal wagon, because otherwise they run away. So yeah. there are death messages for those little critters, but basically you almost never see them.
Well, yeah, I've never seen it. I don't think I've ever died to squirrels. I only recently found out that what the skunk death message was whenever someone collapses. I don't want to spoil it, but yeah, you can die from skunk overdose there. And the other scene that I will say that for some reason has just now started popping up all of the time, and I honestly. I was playing the game for months until I even knew that this existed. Was the future scene where you actually go through the spiral of light and then get transported to modern day. For some reason, that has come up in the past. I don't know. Maybe in the past 20 games, it's probably come up. I'd say 5 or 6 times. And before that, I had never seen it before. Is that one of the more rare ones?
Yeah, I think that's probably the hardest wagon unlock event because it's like right near the end, and it's also pretty rare. I think that's probably the most rare of the wagon related scenes.
Yeah, and I was happy to get it. I got the modern, I got to say. And I think that I don't remember what episode of the wagon adventure that we did for that one, but I could have swore that it was only if you fell when you drive off the cliff, it was only if you have the wand equipped. I thought that was what triggered it, but apparently it wasn't. That's just random, I guess.
Yeah, it's just random. It's somewhat rare.
Yeah, I had never seen it until the first time, which obviously Herp Dirt makes sense. But then after that, it seems like it came up like really, really frequently. And another scene that we were talking about last time you were on that was supposed to be super duper rare was the glitch. And I had seen that, I don't even know, somebody, one of my mods out there, try to estimate how many times have we actually seen the glitch? Because we've seen it for a while, and everyone knows I like to call the buffaloes the upside-down teacup buffaloes, because that's pretty much what they look like. They look like the, I believe it's at Disney World, the spinning teacup rides. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah, Heliware says about 20. Quietron says like 8 or 9. I've seen way more than 8 or 9, I promise. Well, Quietron, she's kind of a newer moderator, so she may not have seen the older versions. But we are, of course, joined here by my good friend Sparse Vector, the creator of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure, as well as the upcoming title Go Plague Monkey Go here on SS Radio number 100, October 3rd, 2013. And Sparse Vector, let's get to a couple of questions just to catch up with you and maybe possibly get a little bit new information on the upcoming title known as Go Plague Monkey Go. What is the development like for Plague Monkey, and how close are we somewhat to seeing an alpha or even possibly a beta build for the game?
I was originally actually hoping to be releasing it like in the next few weeks, but since Super Amazing Wagon Adventure got greenlit, I sort of put it on hold temporarily to work on the update. But I'm still hoping that it'll come out early 2014. It's pretty close to being finished. Like I'd say it's maybe like 80% done.
Now, comparatively speaking, obviously, they're going to be two completely different games, but was there anything that was like so drastically different that it affected the way that you programmed the next game, or were you kind of expecting maybe not from a bug's perspective, but after doing Wagon Adventure, I mean, were you kind of like knowing how the process is going to be for like the next game? Like, was it easier, I guess, is the question, after doing one, or did Plague Monkey provide a whole new set of challenges for you?
I'd say it was a whole new set of challenges. So the new game, it has a not pixel art style, like it's more of like a hand drawn style.
Right.
That's been like a whole new huge challenge for me to produce art of that style. Also with this game, I've tried to make it more sort of like emergent gameplay kind of thing. Like with Wagon Adventure, there's all these set scenes that you can see, but sort of there's a finite number. Like it's not infinite. Like like if you played it as long as you have, you've probably seen everything that can happen.
Right.
So with this game, I'm trying to sort of make it more like simulation driven, so like you could really play it forever, and like and there's still things that you haven't seen because there's just so many different interacting bits.
Now, as far as again, I'm going to try to refrain from comparing Plague Monkey to Sawa. But is there an actual like finite ending, or is it still kind of left open ended, or is this kind of like everyone sails off to the sunset and all the Plague Monkeys are happy type thing? Like, is there more of a story driven based? I don't want to call it quest, but I guess arc, like story arc for the game as compared to Wagon Adventure, or is it more just kind of open ended and we just see who gets the high score and whatnot?
There is going to be an ending to the game. It is more open-ended than Wagon Adventure, I'd say. So, for people who haven't sort of heard the pitch for the game, you're a monkey with a highly fatal disease, and you're sort of dropped in the middle of a city through an accident. And then you try and kill as many people as possible before cops or like army guys catch you or shoot you. And so there is actually an ending to the game, but sort of the main goal is to just run around in the city and kill as many people as possible.
Right. Now, as far as when the game is actually released, are you going to do it through sparsevector.com? Are you looking at trying to get it greenlit in the future on Steam? Or are you going to go through Desura again? Or how's the release going to go for Plague Monkey when it comes out?
Hopefully it'll come out on Steam. I know I haven't actually talked to Valve yet, but now that Super Amazing Wagon Adventure is on Steam or will be on Steam, hopefully it'll be an easier process to get it on Steam,
right.
But if not, then I'll probably go through Greenlight again and hopefully get through it again. So,
well,
yeah.
I mean, obviously the game is going to, I guess, explode more than it already has now that it's been greenlit. And I expect you to have a much easier time with titles getting passed. I'm sure that probably gets your foot in the door with Valve, I mean, exclusively, right? Because, I mean, it's not like too many game developers, especially indie game developers, can say, yeah, my game has actually gotten greenlit these days. Do you think it's going to make it easier to get Plague Monkey up and future titles? What's your feeling on that?
Yeah, I'm not sure if it'll be like an automatic in. Like, I'm not sure if they do that anymore with just like if you already have a game on Steam, you can put as many games on Steam as you want.
Right.
But I think even if that's not the case, hopefully releasing Wagon Adventure on Steam will sort of give me enough of a fan base or like people that want new games to me to get through Greenlight again.
And again, we are still joined by my good friend Sparse Vector, the creator of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure and Go Plague Monkey Go, upcoming title, hopefully in 2014, in the first quarter, I believe. Now, before we get into the trivia part and everything like that, I've got to ask, what is on the horizon for Sparse Vector after Plague Monkey is being released? Have you looked forward? Do you have any thoughts about a new game past Plague Monkey, or possibly are you going to stay as an indie developer? Are you going to possibly join on with somebody else? What does the future hold past Go Plague Monkey Go for Sparse Vector?
I'm hoping to stay an indie developer for as long as I can, basically. I have a bunch of ideas for the next game, and actually like sort of my favorite ideas right now are to try and do not a sequel to Super Amazing Wagon Adventure, but sort of something in the same kind of genre, like something kind of building on what I've learned watching people play Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. and actually sort of inspired by like the sort of stuff that you do, like with streaming it every week and like having people interact with you on stream. I really like that kind of stuff, so I'm hoping to do a game like to cater specifically towards that kind of thing.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, I am a Sparse Vector consumer for life, I think, and honestly, I mean, it's not even fluff at this point that everyone knows that I absolutely adore Super Amazing Wagon Adventure, and like I said, I feel confident enough to ask the creator, do you think I've played more games than anyone except the creator himself? One last question that I was supposed to ask you, and I just remember this one. Before we get to the trivia portion and give away the 5 copies of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure with Sparse Vector here, my fans wanted to know, they told me I needed to ask you, is it possible, they wanted to know, either in Go Plague Monkey Go or a future title, is it possible that we'll see a Sinvicta-based character in a game just because of how many games I've played Wagon Adventure? Again, this is one of the most requested questions besides the what is going to be in the update for Super Amazing Wagon Adventure.
I think that's definitely possible. Like, if I do another game in this style, like, I think it would be cool to put, like, as sort of random default characters, like different streamers and YouTubers and stuff like that who supported the game. So, yeah, I think that's possible.
That'd be awesome. Yeah, there you see the chat going crazy with that. So, all right, we are going to go on to the topic here before we say goodbye to Sparse Vector for the first half of the show. Again, Sparse Vector will be in chat, so if you do have other questions that you would like to direct to him after we go into halftime break here, please feel free. He will be in chat. He can. I'm not going to obligate him to answer every question, but if you do have other questions that you would like to hear from, I guess, from the Sparse Vector mouth, then please ask him there. But we are going to go on, and we are giving away 5 copies of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. Again, these are going to be trivia questions. Again, the my normal followers and my usual fans here and regulars to the show will have a little bit of a leg up, but I want to make it a little bit fair, so not all of them are going to be revolving around what I do for the Super Amazing SS Radio Wagon Adventure. So again, you do have a chance here. If you don't know anything about the game itself, you do have a chance of winning. And again, Sparse Vector will be PMing you through Twitch with game keys. You can, I believe you said that you can redeem these on Desura. Is that correct, Sparse Vector?
Yeah, these are Desura keys, and in a little bit when it launches on Steam, you should be able to convert it to a Steam key then.
Okay, so there you go. So if something doesn't go right with Desura keys, let me know, and I will try to figure it out. But if anything, you just wait for the game to come out on Steam, which, by the way, I guess I should also ask you, what is the time frame looking like for the Steam release of the game?
I don't have a hard release date yet, but hopefully it'll be really soon, like within the next couple of weeks, hopefully.
Okay, so there you go. So even if you win and you don't want to wait, you can still buy the game. But of course, if you do win one of the trivia copies of the game, you won't have to wait that long. Let's get right to it. Question number one, and again, please type your answer only once. My moderators will make sure that you're only typing it once. And again, moderators are free to join in on this trivia as well. Because I realize that most of them are probably, if you don't own the game already, I will say that for the record. And I guess the disclaimer will be, if you don't own the game already, please take part in the trivia. If you do own the game, try to refrain from taking part in these. But I promise you the questions aren't going to be that hard, especially to the ones who have been following the SS Radio Wagon Adventure since the beginning. And here we go. Question number one. What is Sinvicta's most favorite Super Amazing Wagon Adventure weapon of all time? You all have about 20 seconds to put in, and once I see a right answer, I will leave it to Sparse Vector to announce who the winner will be. There is no multiple choice. It is just you're going to know it or you're not going to know it. And like I said, whoever gets the right answer, Sparse Vector will pick just a random name from the person who gets it right. And
I'm not actually 100% sure what the right answer is, but I think, if I were to guess, it would be the Falcon.
That is correct, sir.
And it's, in that case, it's Blue1442 is, I think, the first person to get it.
All right. So congratulations, Blue1442. He is a regular of the show. We'll make sure that again, if you do win. Make sure you check your Twitch PM sometime later on in this week, and I'll be making sure I'm PMing you the keys on Twitch. So make sure you check it, because that's the only way that I'm going to be delivering it. So congratulations, Blue1442. Question number two. Here we go with Sparse Vector and Sinvicta on SS Radio number 100. Question number two. Oh, I got to scroll up for it. There we go. Who is the all-time Survivor Champion for the Super Amazing SS Radio Wagon Adventure? I will give you a hint. It is not a dude. So again, if you don't own the game, you're more than welcome to enter on this. And again, the first person here, Sparse Vector, you may not remember this name, so I'm going to type it for you here in the other client, and that is the correct answer, sir. And you can pick who you want for the winner of the second copy of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure.
So the first person on my chat with the right answer is Helliwr.
Heliwer, yep, there he is. So congratulations, Heliwer, the answer, the all-time reigning queen champion of Super Amazing SS Radio Wagon Adventure. It was even retweeted and acknowledged by Sparse Vector. Is, of course, Angelicar, one of my mods, very, very well known on Twitch for being a super-duper moderator. So congratulations to Heliwer. I will make sure I PM you the I will PM you the key over Twitch, like I said again. Question number three, and then these are going to be the last three questions are going to be more, I guess, generic. I've been hanging around Brits too long, I think. I've been hanging around English people too much. But here we go. The last three questions here are not going to be so tailored to my show, and if you know anything about the game, then you may have a chance to win it. So question number three, exactly how many buffaloes does it take to make a coherent sentence in the English language? And Sparse Vector, of course, he will know that answer. I actually knew the answer, too. But not before playing the game, I will state for the record. I did not know what the reference was, and I think I asked you last time you were on, Sparse Vector. I heard the reference when Yogscast did a coverage of Wagon Adventure, and I asked you what was that reference that Lewis was talking about, because he said something like there's a little bit of reference right there, and I do see the correct answer there. So I will allow you to explain the origin of this question, and then you can pick the winner there as well.
So I see Worm Talon, I think, is the first person to get the answer, and so it's a little bit of sort of linguistics trivia. If you repeat buffalo 8 times, so buffalo, 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 I think I got that right. It's a grammatically correct English sentence, because it's just using buffalo in the different forms of the word, like the place buffalo, and then also the verb, and then the animal. So it's saying like the animal from buffalo that bullies animals from buffalo bullies animals from buffalo, something like that.
So congratulations, I think Wormtalon. Yeah, Wormtalon is the winner of that one, and the correct answer is 8, by the way. So, and again, I had no idea what that was referencing until Sparse Vector actually came on the show and told me. Question number 4: what is a possible boss that can spawn above the water in the River Crossing? And this is going to be the first River Crossing in the game. There is, I believe, there's only one answer to this. Is that correct?
I think there's two, depending upon how you interpret it. But I see Sora Ketchy says pirate, which is the right answer. So there's a pirate ship that can spawn.
Yeah, and I guess the other, because the pirate ship that's the one I was thinking about. But the other boss that you're thinking about was the satellite for the space scene.
Yeah, so I think maybe that counts. It's supposed to be, I guess, kind of above the river.
Well, I meant like floating in the river. I guess I should have reworded that. But I meant the pirate ship. So congratulations to Sorar. I'll make sure. I will make sure that you get the key, and she will do with it as she pleases here. And then the fifth and final question. Again, this is for the last copy of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. And by the way, I will state for the record that these keys are provided by Sparse Vector himself. So make sure you're not thanking me. Don't thank anybody else. Thank Sparse Vector during the break, or just thank him. Thank him 24/7. I don't care. Just make sure you thank it to him. Question, the fifth and final question for the last copy of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure is, what is a possible boss that can spawn beneath the river of the second river? And I do know that this is only one. There's only one answer. I mean the actual boss creature. Unless if there's a scene that I don't know about.
No, I think that's the only boss. And I see Crad99 says it. Squid. Yep. It's a giant squid.
So congratulations to Crad99 for winning the fifth and final copy of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. Again, that key will be PM to you here on Twitch. And again, I want to thank my friend Sparse Vector for supplying those keys. He didn't have to do that. Again, he is providing them to me, so he definitely didn't have to do that. But he was nice enough to join me here for SS Radio 100. And again, I could not be more thankful. Sparse Vector, before we get on with the Ask Me Almost Anything coming out of the break here, I do want to say thanks again for appearing here. And I will leave the floor open to you, sir, before we wrap it up for the first half of SS Radio 100.
Thank you. Thanks for having me on, and congratulations again on a really long-running online radio show.
I appreciate it. I don't know of how many. I'm sure there's probably a lot of podcasts and radio shows out there that do that do the long running thing. But I've had fun, and I'm looking forward to the vacation, I got to be honest. But can we expect another Sparse Vector interview whenever we see Plague Monkey Go come out in the near future, I guess I should say?
Yeah, absolutely. I'd love to come on again on whatever format you have going on then.
it'd be SS Radio. It would be SS Radio. It's going to be the same name. I'm going to keep things relatively the same. I'm going to redo the UI, but other than that, it will still be SS Radio. It will still be on my Twitch channel. I'm just basically taking a short break, I guess, for the rest of the year. But again, if you have questions for Sparse Vector, he is going to stick around to answer questions for the AMA. And also, again, don't forget that I will be doing a special world premiere of the updated version of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure on here. And I forgot. This shows you how newbie I am. I actually forgot to change the ticker. I changed everything else but the freaking ticker in the middle there. I just turned it off. So thank you, Moz, for reminding me about that. Anyway, make sure if you have any questions, you can ask Sparse Vector. He will be sticking around. And then after the AMA, I will be doing a special world premiere of the new version with Sparse Vector, and Husky Starcraft will also be in the game as well. I doubt he's going to be on any sort of call, but I do know that Husky will be paying attention because I'm pretty sure actually he's seen the game a couple times. So once again, Sparse Vector, thank you very much, and I'm looking forward to talking to you in a few, man.
Thanks again for having me on.
And when we come back here, get those questions ready. Get ready to put them out there in chat, because I will be doing the Sinvicta Ask Me Almost Anything for the rest of the show. Again, the show will run as long as I have questions to answer. So if you've ever wanted to know almost everything about me, keep in mind that I do have the right to refuse answering. But I will be opening up a little bit to let you know about your favorite half-Asian radio host and whatnot. So again, one more time, thank you, Sparse Vector. Stick around for the second half of SS Radio 1. The AMA is coming up next in about 2 minutes. Don't go anywhere. This is Sinvicta on SS Radio number 100.